Hello and welcome to this special edition of CGTN. Now I'm in the southern Chinese city of Guangzhou. Of course, happy International Museum Day. This is a very special day all around the world. And I believe everywhere, every country in the world is celebrating this very special day. And now, the southern Chinese city, the Museum of Nanyue King, is hosting a joint exhibition with an Italian museum. And today I'm going to show you something very mysterious, at least I think it's quite mysterious for me. It's Pompeii, and behind we can see is the infinite life Pompeii City. So today I'm going to show you the one and only Pompeii City, but today I'm not alone. I'm also joined by a very special guest who will give us a panoramic picture of what's happened in the past, especially the last day of the Pompeii City and how people in the Pompeii City used to live before they were buried. So hello, welcome to this program. Would you like to say hi to our viewers around the world and tell us something about yourself?
我叫何少伟，是南雍王博物馆的讲解员，今天就由我来带各位参观这个展览。Okay,
so he is going to be our guide today, and we're going to show you just now I mentioned the whole Pompeii city, how people used to live, especially on the last day, actually. And also, if you have any questions, please leave your comments down below on Facebook, Weibo, Twitter, and if you like our post and please share it with your friends so that more of us would get what happened in the Pompeii City before it was buried. So let's get started, right? Pompeii City, let's move on. And the first thing that I noticed when I walked into this museum is this one. It's very much like a plate, like a blackboard, right? What is it? Tell us something about it. 这是关于什么的?
这一个是他们选举的时候，那些公民会帮那些人拉票，然后呢就在墙上面写了很多标语，比如说这一个，给某一个人财政官这个职位，选举他。So
this is for voting, right? Okay, and I would like to get more votes from the from my constituency, probably, and then I would ask them to vote for me, right? That is what happened. And it is very modern, actually. It looks really modern. Okay, so let's move on to the next thing. I found something probably people in Pompeii City used to use in the past. And I can see some tools. Quite modern. Tell us something about them.
这一些的话呢,是他们生活上面平民用的一些工具。举个例子啊,他们修房子。
Ordinary people, right? Ordinary people, what they used. And then, what is it?
比如说这一个我们现在还在用的锤子啊。
Hammer.
对，这一个斧头.
Axe.
对，这一个是修房子用的那种垂直线啊。The
plumb line, right? Yeah, that is what we use when during construction, right?
对。还有等等，比如说这巨型的龟啊之类的，都是一些生产工具，那平方面的。Yeah,
they used to be really actually advanced when it comes to some technology, especially in construction, right? So we have axe and we also have hammer. And the plumb line especially, and the square, that is very much similar to what we use even today, right? 跟我们现在用的也是差不多的。That is what happened. Yeah, for those who just tuned in, this is CGTN, and we are broadcasting live in the southern Chinese city of Guangzhou. This is the International Museum Day, and here in the Museum of Nanyue King of the Western Han Dynasty, and we are hosting a joint exhibition with an Italian museum to show the viewers, especially museum goers, of the Pompeii city, a panoramic picture of what happened. And now we have come to the next place. What is it? Tell us something about this place. This is so beautiful. I can see beautiful paintings and also some figurines and sculptures. And so tell us something about this. I'm pretty sure a lot of museum goers would be very much interested in it.
这个是庞贝人的一个门厅，就相当于一进门一个大厅来。So
this is very much like the courtyard, right? A courtyard. And what do they have? Yeah, we can see if we turn the camera around. Yeah, I know, like people would be more interested in the figurines, but we're gonna come back to them later. If we turn it around, we can see that's the courtyard, right? It's very much like the sihore in Chinese, in China, like the quadruple courtyard in China, especially in the capital Beijing. So tell us something special about it. I know it is shaking around. It's very much like the volcanic eruption about to happen.
后面那个就是毁灭了庞贝的火山，维苏威火山，然后现在就模仿了一个火山跟地震的一个情况。哦，so
this is the simulation or the picture, the video is about what happened in the past on the last day of Pompeii city. The volcanic eruption and everything was destroyed tragically and fortunately, right? Okay. It is rolling and it keeps rolling, right? So now let's come to the figurines. Let's turn around. Let's talk about the figurines. Or the paintings first, anyways, so we are here. So tell us something about the paintings. And let's start with this one.
这一些都是他们在房子里面装饰的壁画。The
frescoes, right?
对，然后呢，都是画了一些他们喜欢的神灵。他们庞贝人是多神崇拜的，这些都是各种神灵。So
they used to observe polytheism, right? So they have different gods for different things, very much like in China, right? Polytheism, and then they moved on to monotheism. And this one, yeah, just now, was flying couple. Yeah, and this one, it looks very different.
就是酒神，庞贝人喜欢喝酒，所以他们很崇拜这个神灵。
Okay, so it is Dionysus. I know Dionysus actually is in Greek and Roman mythologies. 他这个酒神应该是在古希腊罗马神话里边的。是庞贝人的话, they also observe the same thing.
共通的都是。
Okay, so they had something a lot in common actually, right? Dionysus. Okay, so now let's move on to the figurines here. And I can see tons of them, and lots of our viewers actually are very much interested or into them. It's very tiny, so we can zoom in a little bit so that they can have a close look at the figurines here. It is so tiny, and what is it? Figurine Mercury.
这一些小雕像啊，比如说下面那一个是速度，代表速度，商业的一个守护神。
Mercury, right?
Yeah.
Mercury, let me see. Yeah, when it comes to the planets we have in the solar system, the first one is Mercury. 这个我们这个九大行星里边，第一个是太阳系里边就是 Mercury, 是吧？就是水星。And it is about, it's about business, right?
对，商业。 商业.
Why? How come it's about business? Now you know something about Greek and Roman mythology, probably.
您可以看看它右左手啊，或者左手有一个
in the left hand.
对，左手那一个权杖，它上面其实是代表它一个速度，对，商业。
About speed.
对，商业.
How come speed and business could be associated with each other?
是讲究那一个怎么说，就。 转换交换那个要讲究速度。So
you are always on the move, right? It is about, it is the key of business, right? You're always on the move. So they have something. Yeah, in the left hand, it is very much like a cane, and then it means speed, right? Mercury, it's about business. So we have this one.
这个伊西斯啊是埃及的神灵，但庞贝人他吸纳了他们别的国家的神灵。So
Isis used to be from Egypt, right? Oh, but they absorbed this one, the culture of Egypt. They associate the culture with the Pompeii culture somehow. So it was very much, I think Pompeii used to be very advanced in technology, also quite popular, and they would like to take in different cultures, right? Uh-huh. So, how about that one on top?
最高的那一个是他们的，可以说是祖先的神灵。 他们除了各种神灵崇拜之外，还崇拜祖先。Okay,
so ancestor, right? Ancestry, figurine of genius, but is it figurine of genius? So if I worship the figurine, I could be a genius probably someday, hopefully. Okay, so we have got some comments on Weibo or Facebook, and the first one is asking, where is it? Yeah, for those who just tuned in, this is the southern Chinese city, and the museum is the Nanyue King Museum, the museum of the Nanyue King of the Western Han Dynasty. And then someone is also asking, I think that is called, hopefully I'm pronouncing your name correctly, it is Samantha Tapa. How many years old? So how many years old for the whole thing?
27.
No, not for you. Yeah. Yeah, about this whole museum and about the artifact.
One year.
1 year?
Yeah.
No, about the artifacts, 关于这个整个的所有的这些历史庞贝城，还有我们的 museum, 我们的博物馆里边的展馆的 artifacts 大概有多少年？
我在这里当了7年志愿者，然后工作了1年。
Okay. Yeah. Anyways, you always would like to make the question about you. Yeah, I was asking like, how old is the museum and the artifacts? 还有我们所有这个艺术的展品大概有多少年的历史？大概2000多年吧。
这一个展品，这一个大概接近2000年。
Nearly 2,000 years, right? For the artifacts of the Pompeii city, right?And that is Pompeii City, and also for the museum. How about the artifacts in our museum? Also about 2,000 years, right?
我们馆的比它，比这个大概多100年吧，2100年。
Okay, 2,100 years for the artifacts of the museum of your museum, the Chinese one, right? And now we're looking at the Italian ones, the Italian artifacts, and they are about 2,000 years.Quite similar, actually. Yeah, hopefully I have answered your question. And also, someone is asking, 这个雕塑是铁制的吗? Yeah, the figurine, is this made of... Yeah, it is copper.
青铜做的。
So it is, they're all made of copper in the past. Okay, so we can see the erosion. That's why I think it should be copper, right? Okay, so now let's move on to the next place, probably something more interesting.Yeah, for those who just tune in, this is the International Museum Day, and I can see a lot of visitors, museum goers, coming to this place. They will have come really early so that we can avoid the crowd. So it is in China, it's around 9 something. If you're in America, it could be at night. You're a little bit, we are a little bit ahead of you guys. So now I've come to this place, we can see, yeah, it is actually a bust.In English, we call it bust, a masculine bust. So tell us something about it. Something special about this particular one.
这一个是庞贝人以希腊罗马的雕像用青铜做出来的一个复原的东西。
So this is very much like a replica, like a one-to-one replica from the Greek and Roman the statues. I know the Greek and Roman statues are usually made of marble, right? 大理石做的。但这个的话 this is made of copper.Okay, they have a lot of things actually made of copper somehow, probably. That place used to be abundant with copper resources somehow. 但那个地方以前青铜可能资源比较丰富。
其实还可以，还可以。对，他们除了本地的之外，还可以进行贸易。对。
So the trade actually was very advanced, so they could trade with others to getting to taking some copper from other countries, right?Okay, so let's turn around and look and see a naked statue here. And this one is Apollo. This one is Apollo. 这个是阿波罗。
对对对，没错。但我们普通知道阿波罗是太阳神。
Yeah, the sun god or the god of sun, right? I know, that is my, like, according to my understanding, Apollo should be the god of sun. But for this one, it's the god of...Instruments, music.
对，音乐之神，留意一下他他的左手。
The left hand.
对，有一个琴。嗯。他其实阿波罗除了是太阳神之外，他也是代表音乐的一个神灵。
So besides the sun, it's also the god of music, right? Yeah, the statue of Apollo. I can see an instrument. It's very much like a mini harp. 它有点像一个小型的竖琴一样哈。
它其实是上面那一小部分才是。那个长条的那个是给它支撑用的。
I think that is made to prop up the statue, right? The stick of there under the left hand, but the one in his hand, the left hand is the instrument. It's very much like mini harp, as I said just now. 它有点像一个小的竖琴一样。
对对对对。
Yeah, by the way, can't see. It is eroded somehow. 这个雕塑它也上了很多的锈了，现在。
对，没错，它也是有点氧化吧。生锈了有点点。
Okay, so we have got some comments from Carmen Gordon. Carmen Gordon is saying that is a beautiful museum in China. Thank you very much. But this is not like the Chinese artifacts. This is a joint exhibition between Italian museum and the Chinese one. The Chinese one is the Museum of Nanyue King in the southern Chinese city of Guangzhou. And the Italian museum, they sent over some of the artifacts they have. So they have the joint exhibition in the Chinese Museum. So this is the International Museum Day, and everywhere, every museum in China is free to the public.
今年的公众博物馆日是所有都免费开放的。对，免费，我免费开放。
So all the museums in China are free to the public on the International Museum Day, right? It could be really hectic for you guys on these days. So let's move on to something about their daily lives in the past. And we saw some figurines, some gauze, and also some copper statues. And now we have moved on to something different. I see something quite big. It is very much like a container. Or probably it's, what is it? Tell us something about it.
这就是磨面包用的石磨。
It's something like a grinder. Yeah, we can see it here. Grinder of lava to make bread. But this is so big.
但还挺大。很大，而且推起来很困难。
Okay.
很重,
so it could probably take them a lot of effort to grind the lava for bread.
人力甚至是畜生的力量就去推动的,就拉动的,
So like China, they used to use animals, right?
对,
okay. To move it around the whole thing. This is so big. So let's turn around. I know on the last day of Pompeii, the city actually, it was buried because of the tragic volcanic eruption. So everything actually was charred. And now we can see some of the artifacts. I think they're all replicas. 这些都是复原品,复制品。原本的。 Everything is authentic here. So this is authentic. This is charred bread.
这个是焦烧焦的面包。面包对，这种面包就是用刚才那个墨给磨出来，然后火山爆发，火山灰包住了它之后呢，它就碳化了，就所以保存下来很好。Okay,
so they use the grinder to make the bread, and the bread was charred on the last day of the city. Now we can see the charred bread, and we can also see some charred onions here, right? And they are protected because they are charred, of course. That is a good way to preserve like cultural relics, of course. And we can see vase basket, we can see everything like the pot and the casserole. And I'm more interested here, if we turn the camera around, something like the group of five weights. Five weights, the weights they used to use. And I could see some dots, right? We can see some dots. So if we zoom in a little bit, we can see on top, on the surface of the weight, we can see some dots. I think that is some kind of measurement, probably. 它这个上面有一些点是来。哦，它只是有一点点残损而已，就有点点烂而已。嗯，没什么的。基本上是用石头来做的这些秤砣。Oh, all the weights were made of stone, right? Okay, and we can see something here. It is very much like the weights, and I can see a beautiful figurine. I think that is also a weight, right? It's so beautiful.
对，也是一个秤砣，秤砣对，特别是那个砣，那个造型是一个女性的，很漂亮。So
it is like a woman figurine, right? Like also the bust of a woman, and it's called the bronze scale. They used to have a lot of exquisitely made things, very beautiful. Okay, so we have got some comments from our viewers. The first one is, 为什么这个青铜看起来是铜色那个小雕像? So they were asking, yeah, but we were far away from the bust. So they were asking why is that copper looks a little bit greenish. But for all of the figurines, actually, they were black. 为什么他们那个小的是黑色的,那个青铜的是绿色?
其实它... 保存环境还有就是它本身的成分会造成它颜色有点不一样的。哦，so
that really depends on like the not the ingredients but the materials they used to make the figurines and also the statue bust over there, right? Yeah, but unfortunately we can't go back. But hopefully we have answered the question. So we have another one that is from Usha Kiran Murmu. Hopefully I have pronounced your name correctly. So it is good to know about Pompeii, and it is knowledgeable for me. Thanks. Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you so much, guys. So we have moved on to something, like we can see pots made of pottery, right? It's pottery, made of clay. Kettles.
这一些是他们一个装酒,或者装一些鱼酱。
鱼酱。
对,庞贝人呢,他是 临海，所以做很多那种鱼酱，然后卖到罗马那里给他们做菜。
So, Pompeii used to be a coastal city， 它是一个海边城市。Pompeii used to be a coastal city， and so they would store some 鱼酱 like caviar。Very expensive.
烹饪的时候就可以用到很多这种调料、鱼酱之类的东西。
So in cooking, they used to use caviar, and they would store. They used to store the caviar in the kettles, right? Coastal city.
还有就是装酒，他们葡萄酒很出名。
Okay, they also put some wines into the pottery. Okay, it's very much like the pottery we have in China. Something different about them.它跟中国的也有很像，它这个和中国有什么不一样？
这个瓶子基本上
the bottom,
对、
right.
都是尖底的，他们放的时候就是地上有个坑，然后整一个给套进去。
So the bottom, if we zoom in a little bit, the bottom is very pointy. So they would place the whole thing, the pottery, in the ground, right? They dig a hole and then put the pottery in it. Why? Why do they do that? 为什么？
因为这些东西主要是储存用的，它不是平常我们像茶壶那样倒出来，不是，它是主要是储存。
So they were used for storage, right? And that's it. So they didn't use them as kettles like the teapots we do now, right? So they just place them in the hole in the past. And we also see something about utensils, cooking stuff. I see something quite modern now. I know it has a history of.Around 2,000 years, right? It says here, the label, it said 1 century AD. So about 2,000 years, and can see something quite modern. It's something like plates and bowls and the glass wine glass. 是吧？这个现在看起来还挺现代的。这个他们当时有这样的工艺吗？
对，其实罗马那一带啊，一世纪的玻璃已经很多当生活用品了。就像这些都是当杯子、当盆子来装东西的。
Okay, so they used to have the technology already, very advanced. We can see a bowl, and the bowl is a little bit shiny. I think the bowl is probably made of like seashells. 是当时的贝壳做的吗？
主要是沙子。
Sand.
对，中国当时其实也有，不过一般是用来当装饰品，比如说腰带上面装饰的。欧洲那边主要是用来当一些容器。
So in China, we used to have something like this before around that period, right? But in China, everything was used for decoration, especially for the royal family. I'm afraid, like on your belt or something. 应该是中国当时的皇家可能用的是比较多的。
其实除了皇家，百姓平民也用。
Like ordinary people in the past, 2,000 years ago in the Han Dynasty, right?
对，就比如说吧，皇家的话。我们南王墓他就腰上面出了很多装饰的玻璃，但是如果像平民，像我们长沙，出了很多那些用玻璃做的装饰品都有的，平民。
So ordinary people used to use them too, right? Yeah. So the Han Dynasty around 2,000 years ago, and Pompeii city around 2,000 years ago, nearly around the same period of time, and we used to have something like quite similar, like the bowls.But we used to use them for decoration, but they used them as kitchen utensils. Okay, so now let's move around, let's continue. We can see masks, and we can also see some frescoes. They have very unique cultures. Here, I can see a mask over there, the paintings. Very scary looking. What is it?
These are all their face paintings and face paintings.
So I can see, yeah, we call them frescoes of relief, right, with two masks, but they look really scary. I don't know what culture that was. 这是什么样的文化？为什么有这样的面具呢？中国和亚洲文化是很少有的 ，right? We don't have that in the Asian cultures, so we didn't have those in the Asian cultures.
他们这些面具主要是演戏剧的时候用的。一个用途是。表现那个感情，就像中国那种京剧。
For theatrical performances in the past, right? It's very much like the Peking opera we have. We paint our faces, but they used to have the masks.
还有第二个用途吧，它就是把那个声音让它洪亮。
Okay.
对，把声音放出来，它是有这个功能的。
So they used to wear the mask to make their sound more resonant.
像扩音器。
They could make their sounds more resonant, right? To amplify.Their sound. Okay, now let's move on to the next thing. If you have any questions, please leave your comment. And now we have finished half of the exhibitions about the Pompeii city. And of course, it is according to you guys. If you want to see more about the Chinese side of the artifacts, leave a comment down here and let us know if you want to see something about China as well, about 2,000 years ago, around the same period. Let us know. Leave your comments. I can see that. I have my phone in my hand now. So let's move on to the next part of the Pompeii city. Okay, I know Pompeii city is like in Italy. They used to have something quite erotic. Yeah, that was part of the culture. They used to have a lot of public bathrooms, and we can see it here. But a lot of viewers probably, if you're under two marble statues here, tell us something about them.
这一个的话呢，是他们。
of agriculture. This is, yeah, this is the he. So it used to be very agricultural, right? Yeah, before it was buried. 他们以前还是农业比较重要。农业跟渔业。 Fishery and agriculture, right? So yeah, now we can see in the shot, and the god of agriculture is holding, the right hand is holding grapes.
对，因为他们葡萄酒很出名，因为他们的葡萄种植很好。
Oh, they were really well known for the grapes they have, especially grape wine. Uh-huh. Very beautiful looking. But yeah, when I look at the face, for me, I think for a lot of our viewers, I'm really, you see the faces actually are quite similar to me. 我觉得他们的脸好像是看不出来他们到底是哪个人是有任何的区别的，是吧？就可能很写实，但是的话呢，表情不是说非常的准确吧，有时候都。
So
the facial expression is bland, right? We could say the facial expression is very bland. So we don't see much in the facial expression, but you can tell like which figure is which by looking at the things they hold, probably in their hand, and also the statue and the posture and everything, right? Okay, so let's now move on to something about home. I know we can see a home environment, right? The home and environment. So we're gonna go to a home probably of some of the Pompeii residents in the past.
我们要去他们的家庭生活中的不一样的。其实刚才一个总数就是家庭生活。对，但是到了最后这一部分，主要是一个最后一天，庞贝的最后一天，就是。
So we have come to the last part of Pompeii City, the last day of Pompeii City. And we know because of the tragic volcanic eruption and the city was buried, right? Like 2,000 years ago, and now we're gonna come to this this room, and we're gonna see a video and also a statue that is lying on the ground face down. Yeah, probably you can have a look at this the video. Yeah, before we come to the statue, we're gonna talk about the cast later. So we're gonna see. This is the video about the last day of Pompeii City before the eruption.
它是以一个庞贝人的视觉讲了最后一天发生了什么事情。So
we're looking at from the viewpoint of a Pompeii resident in the past, and the video tells something about what happens in the on the last day, right? So let's have a look. So I probably will stop talking so that you can enjoy the video. It is not very long. How long is it? 不会太长。
大概三分钟左右。
Oh, it's about 3 minutes. So we're gonna have a look at. Let's have a look at the video. It's about 3 minutes. So, both of us will stop talking. If you have any questions, please leave your comments down below. So let's enjoy the video now.
He
这一段就是他自己的自述，回忆他一生发生什么事情。
So he's talking about his life, right? The whole thing, quite reminiscent.
他先是一个奴隶出生，然后呢被主人解放了。
So the guy used to be a slave, but he was freed by his master.
然后解放之后呢，他经商，到了大概五十岁吧，他就很有钱，很富有了。但是最后一天他之所以会在家里面去世的原因就是他不舍得他的财富。
So after he was freed, he went to do business, right? But he was buried under the ashes because he didn't want to let go of all of his riches and wealth.
这个场景他其实讲述就是火山爆发的时候他家里面怎么地震然后着火。
Okay, so this is the last day, about the last moment is about to happen, right? The volcano is erupting somehow, probably at the initial stage, and it is not raining, it is showering with like fires and everything.
对，后面那一座喷发的就是他们的维苏威火山嘛。
So that is the Vesuvius volcano, right? Okay, there was a huge earthquake, right? 10 years before it was buried.
然后，但是当地人他已经对地震习以为常。
So they were very much used to the earthquakes in the past.
对，然后就忽略了那一次提醒，造成十多年后这一个火山喷发的时候，大概有10,000多人。对，光是庞贝一个城就大概有10,000多人去世。
Okay, so about 10,000 people were buried in the ashes, right, on the last day, because they were totally ignoring the warnings about the volcanoes.
有些是以为就是小喷发，有一些呢就是不舍得他的财富，还有一些是奴隶要跟着主人不能走，各种原因。
Quite various reasons, right, for the death of so many people, right? Some of them didn't want to leave behind the wealth they have. Some of them are so loyal to their masters. Some of them were, what is this? They didn't want to leave their homes.
比如说吧，这一位就是他舍不得他的财富。有一些是想在家里面躲过那个灾难，没想到灾难太可怕了，就连房子的顶盖都。
So the main character here didn't want to leave behind the riches he has, so he probably, some of them, a lot of them wanted to probably stay put in their household so that they could be saved probably from the ashes, from the skies. Okay. Anyways, the video seems longer than I expected, so let's talk about the plaster cast, okay, lying face down here.
这一个肖像是这样子，火山灰掩埋了庞贝人，然后尸体腐烂之后，里面有个空洞。
OK。
19世纪考古学家就把石膏灌到那个空洞里面，就复原出当时他们最后一刻的造型。
So this is the replica, right? It's made of plaster. Like on the last moment, everything was buried in the ashes, right? And then after probably 1,000 years or hundreds of years, and the body decayed.And after that, some of the archaeologists, they cast some plaster into the vacuum. And so that they have this plaster cut right now. So this is very much the simulation of how people probably spent the last minute of their lives. This is a he or she, we can't tell. This is the woman, this is the she.
对，是一个女性的雕像。这一种石膏啊。这种空腔在庞贝大概有2,000个空洞。
There were over 2,000 of them in Pompeii now, in Italy, the Museum of Italian Museum.
空洞大概有2,000多个，这种石膏像的话呢，有上百个。
So statues like this, the number of them could be around 200, right? Okay.But you're talking about the holes, right? Yeah, I mean, I probably misunderstood you. The holes actually 2,000 of them, but statue the plaster cast like this one, probably 200 of them in Italy.
这种雕像它就可以复原出当时 最后一刻庞贝人是多么的绝望的，就各种身份的人在最后一刻经历了同一个灾难之后，都是面对一个很恐怖的事情。
Okay, the last moment of the Pompeii city, everyone was in despair because they ignored the warnings of the volcano, the potential volcanic eruption, or everything. Yeah, for those who just tuned in, and I said just now, oh yeah, someone was asking us questions again. I think this one is from Weibo. It's like the official expression is bland and I don't see eyeballs. Yeah, probably you can answer this question, and your major is about history, right? Like Chinese history, and you also learned something about the statues in China. How come, yeah, for all of the statues, they don't have eyeballs somehow? But in China, I know in Chinese culture, they would try to, I know the eyeballs and the eyes are usually a very important part of the painting of the statue. 在这中国的文化里边，它这个眼睛其实点睛的是最重要，但他们的文化里边好像不重要。
其实他们也有，他们会用玻璃来做眼睛。对，刚才有不少。
They use the glass balls as eyes.
对，用玻璃来做。刚才有不少雕像也是用那种不同于绿色，而是黑，有点黑色透明的感觉的，当眼睛用的。他们也是。
They also have like eyeballs, we said, right? But made of different materials. Like you use what is it? Glass, right? Yeah, glass balls. So someone is asking a question.我中途加入了直播，这是广州哪里？南越王墓吗？ Yeah, someone is asking if this is Guangzhou. Yeah, this is Guangzhou, and the southern Chinese city for outside China, and this is the Museum of the Nanyue King of the Western Dynasty. Yeah, it's quite a tongue-twisting name anyways. So you can call it the Museum of Nanyue King. And just now, we went through the whole thing about Pompeii City, and this is the International Museum Day. All of the museums in China are free to the public. So if you are a museum goer, definitely visit museums for free. This is Saturday, and you can enjoy your days, and you can also get some knowledge, of course. And we're in the southern Chinese city of Guangzhou, and we finished the Pompeii City part. So I asked you guys if you want to know something about like the Chinese artifacts in the Museum of Nanyue King, and we have some artifacts actually very precious, like some of the most precious treasures in China, which were never allowed outside this country. If you want to know that, leave your comments and we can bring you guys to those places. Okay, 我们南越王墓呢，它其实也有我们自己的这个特别特别宝贵的Treasures, like anything you would like to show us. 你有一些可以带我们去看的一件两件的珍宝是吧？
当然可以，当然可以。
Okay, sure, let's go. Yeah, if you are, which way do we go? Let's go that way, right? That's the exit. So it could be around 3 minutes walk. Okay, we finished Pompeii City. And now, could be to just bear with us, probably around 3 minutes, and then we're going to move on to the next place where we can see.Something about China, Pompeii City about 2,000 years ago, and how about China in the Western Han Dynasty, also about 2,000 years ago, but China, for this museum, the artifacts were 100 years older. So we go that way, right? So we, some flight of stairs. Careful.
在南王墓出了一件用玉做的杯子。
So we're gonna see the cup.The cup made of jade.
对，然后它的造型呢是跟庞贝的一种叫莱通杯的很像。
So we call the cup. It is called. What do we call this again? It's a Lighton, right? In English.
它是莱通是一个音的翻译。
So that's the transliteration from English or probably from other languages, Greek, I guess, into Chinese, right? So we're gonna see something quite different here.And this part is a little bit dark. Yeah, this is the museum. Okay, so we have come to this place. This is one and only, what do you call it? Jade drinking vessel, a rhino horn shape, right? So it is very exquisite. I know this is one of the treasures in the museum, or probably in all across China, that was never allowed outside of China. 这个是从来没有出了中国的一个门。
对，它是不允许出进展览的。
Why?But yeah,
太珍贵了。它是汉代唯一一件 用玉做的绞刑碑是出土的。
It was the only one like 2,000 years ago unearthed properly, right? Okay. So tell us something special about it. We just visited some of the artifacts from Pompeii city all the way in Europe, in Italy right now, and now we have come back to China, like 2,000 years ago. Okay. So tell us something about it.这个它有什么特别特别珍贵的地方 ？It is made of jade, I know. Anything about it, like the carvings and everything. 它这雕刻也和以前不一样吗？和其他的艺术品？
第一个点就是它的造型，它是一个角，跟庞贝那种来通的造型是很像的。对，庞贝是用来祭神，这一个的话呢，可能是用来就普通的喝酒。
I think that's the connection between the Chinese and Italian culture, right? They used to have something quite similar, like horn-shaped cup, right? And they used to use the horn-shaped cups to worship the gods, right? To do some rituals. And for us, what do we do again? 我们是用做什么？
用来喝酒。
We use them to drink wines, right?
它表面的话呢，它是一只神兽，我们中国一种龙啊。龙给缠起，绕了三圈，缠起了整个杯子。
So it's a dragon. On the surface, the carving you can see is like the Chinese dragon, right? Yeah, dragon. I know. If you are from Europe or America, probably you think dragon is some kind of vicious animal. But in Chinese culture, dragon is, yeah, very much like it symbolizes wealth. Also, something.But anything good about Chinese culture, that is the dragon, the Chinese dragon, right?
还有就是您可以看看杯子里面。
Yeah, let's look at the inside. Let's look at the inside of this cup.
它是一直挖到底，很薄，大概两毫米左右的厚度。
It is very thin, okay, and it is about the surface. I think the outside is only around 2 millimeters.It's quite thin, as you can see, the hole goes into the very deeper part of that horn.
对，没错。还有就是这个杯子它，站不稳。
It can't stand itself.
对对对，站不稳。所以关于它当时就2000年前的人怎么放着它，现在还不是很清楚。
So we still don't know how people use them, right? Because the cup can't stand on its own, right? So we didn't know how people in the past used it. Probably the has something like the prop up something that to make it stand on its own. Yeah, they used to drink wine with it, but how, right? You have to hold it at all times to ensure that you don't spill the wine.
近段时间有一个电视剧啊，就《权力的游戏》，它是
Game of Thrones. I think a lot of our viewers around the world would be fans of Game of Thrones, and they used to have something like this.
《权力游戏》里面出的很多这种就绞刑的杯子，他们也是用来喝酒的。对，就当时
in the drama Game of Thrones, they have something like this horn-shaped cups to drink wine.
然后这种杯子的话就。在欧洲吧，这种绞刑的杯子在欧洲生活上面用，祭祀里面也用。中国人的话呢，宴会上面也会用到。
Okay, so in Europe, in ancient Europe, right? 在古代的欧洲 ，in ancient Europe, they used to have the horn-shaped cups to drink, also to worship. But in China, we also used them in some classy, probably balls, and we also have something like this, right? But not now. Okay. Okay, I think that's we have to call it a day. Thank you so much. This is the International Museum Day. Yeah, for the museum goers, definitely go to all of the museums in China, everywhere you are. And then all of the museums are free in China, the International Museum Day. This is the Nanyue King, the Museum of the Nanyue King in the southern Chinese city of Guangzhou. And we are co-hosting the art exhibition about the Pompeii city in the southern Chinese museum. And of course, if you are in Guangzhou right now, definitely come for a visit. And this is not really crowded. Most probably this is the morning. It's really hot now, about 30 degrees Celsius in China. Definitely, hello everyone. If you like our post, share our post with your friends and give us a heart. And also, I'm going to see you next time. See you. Bye-bye. Have a nice day. Would you like to say goodbye to our friends?
Goodbye.
Yeah, very shy. Goodbye. Bye-bye. I'm going to see you next time. Bye-bye.